Macmillan Audio presents The Nazi Menace. Hitler, Churchill, Roosevelt, Stalin, and the Road to War. By Benjamin Carter Hett. Read for you by Raphael Corkhill. For Karina. Cast of characters. The Germans. Ludwig Beck, 1880 to 1944, chief of the general staff of the army from 1933 to 1938, Beck gradually became disillusioned with Hitler and by 1938 had moved into full-scale opposition to the regime. Franz Bernheim, 1899 to 1990. A salesman who was fired from a department store job in Gleiwitz, Upper Silesia, in 1933. He brought a petition to the League of Nations in Geneva protesting Nazi discrimination in Upper Silesia that, because of the unusual treaty status of the region, succeeded. Johannes Blaskowitz, 1883 to 1948. A general who was briefly the military commander in occupied Poland in 1939 and 1940, he repeatedly protested SS atrocities against Jews and other groups. Werner von Blomberg, 1878 to 1946. Hitler's Minister of War from 1933 to 1938. Although subservient to Hitler, he was dismissed from his office in 1938 amid a sensational sexual scandal. Walter von Brauchitsch, 1881 to 1948, Commander-in-Chief of the Army from 1938 to 1941. Brauchitsch was too weak-willed to oppose Hitler's plans, even when he knew they would be disastrous. Wilhelm Canaris, 1887 to 1945. An admiral and chief of Germany's main intelligence service, the Abwehr. Devious and secretive, he turned the Abwehr into a haven for the resistance. Hans Heinrich Dieckhoff, 1884 to 1952. German ambassador to the United States from 1937 to 1938. Hans von Donani, 1902 to 1945. A brilliant jurist and Supreme Court judge from a young age, he became one of the core members of the anti-Nazi resistance. Gerhard Engel, 1906 to 1976. Hitler's army adjutant, or liaison officer to the army, from 1938 to 1943. Werner von Fritsch, 1880 to 1939. Commander-in-Chief of the Army from 1934 to 1938. Although not ideologically opposed to Nazism, Fritsch grew increasingly worried by Hitler's recklessness. Like Blomberg, he was driven from office by a sexual scandal. Max and Margot Fürst, 1905 to 1978 and 1912 to 2003. Left-wing activists and bohemians in Berlin before the Nazi takeover. Max was a furniture maker and Margot a legal secretary. Their Jewish background and connections to radical politics drove them to emigrate in 1935. Hans Bernd Gisevius, 1904 to 1974. A civil servant, intelligence officer, and major figure in the anti-Nazi resistance. As one of the few survivors of the resistance, he became one of its most important chroniclers after World War II. Joseph Goebbels, 1896 to 1945. A failed writer with a doctorate in literature who became a smashing success as the Nazi Party's chief propagandist and minister of popular enlightenment and propaganda after 1933. One of the few Nazi insiders whom Hitler respected and found interesting to talk to. Karl Gödler, 1884 to 1945. a former mayor of Leipzig and price commissioner under Hitler, who became the leader of the civilian side of the anti-Nazi resistance movement. Hermann Göring, 1893 to 1946. A dashing First World War fighter pilot who became one of the leading Nazis and held many high offices under Hitler, including commander-in-chief of the Luftwaffe and head of the Four-Year Plan Authority. Helmut Großkurt, 1898 to 1943. A deeply religious, highly principled intelligence officer whose moral repugnance at Nazi crimes drove him into determined resistance activity. Eva Grun, 1913 to 1978. A former prostitute and pornographic model in Berlin, she married Minister of War Blomberg in early 1938, precipitating a major scandal. Heinz Guderian, 1888 to 1954. A senior German army commander and one of the main advocates and tacticians of fast-moving armored formations. Franz Halder, 1884 to 1972. A cerebral army officer who was chief of the army general staff from 1938 to 1942. Although he was contemptuous of Hitler and close to resistance circles, his willingness to participate in a coup fluctuated wildly. Ulrich von Hassel, 1881 to 1944. A senior diplomat and ambassador, one of many fired in the purge of early 1938. After his dismissal, he gravitated toward the resistance. Count Wolf Heinrich von Helldorf, 1896 to 1944. A dissolute aristocrat and war veteran, he became the commander of the Nazi stormtroopers in Berlin and later Berlin's police chief. Nonetheless, by 1938, he had joined the resistance. Heinrich Himmler, 1900 to 1945. From 1929, the head of the SS, the rapidly growing paramilitary and police organization. By the late 1930s, he was one of the most powerful and dangerous men in Germany. Adolf Hitler, 1889 to 1945. An obscure First World War veteran who became leader of the National Socialist German Workers' Party, then Chancellor of Germany in 1933, and Chancellor and Führer from 1934. Friedrich Hossbach, 1894 to 1980. Hitler's Armed Forces Adjutant, liaison to all branches of the armed forces, from 1934 to 1938. Stubborn, fearless, and of unshakable integrity, he was one of the most important witnesses to developments around Hitler before early 1938. Wilhelm Keitel, 1882 to 1946, an army officer who was given the position of Chief of the OKW, Supreme Command of the Armed Forces, in the shakeup of early 1938. But Keitel was a mediocre nonentity and yes-man to Hitler, whom other senior officers mocked for his subservience. Erich Kurt, 1903 to 1969. A diplomat who in the late 1930s was working at the Foreign Office in Berlin when he became involved in the resistance movement, along with his brother, Theo. Theo Kurt, 1892 to 1962. A diplomat who was working at the German embassy in London in the late 1930s when he became involved in the resistance movement. Wilhelm Ritter von Leeb, 1876 to 1956. A senior and highly respected army commander who tried to organize a coup against Hitler in late 1939. Erich Ludendorff, 1865 to 1937. Deputy commander of the German army in the second half of the First World War and the main architect of Germany's total mobilization in that war. In the 1920s and 30s, he was one of the leading theorists of total war and what it meant for a totalitarian society, in which capacity he strongly influenced Adolf Hitler. Erich von Manstein, 1887 to 1973. Widely considered the most gifted of Hitler's generals, he was the main architect of the sickle-cut plan for the attack on France in 1940. Arthur Niebuhr, 1894 to 1945. A senior criminal police officer and originally ardent Nazi who, like Count von Helldorf, gravitated to the resistance by 1938. Konstantin von Neurath, 1873 to 1956. An establishment conservative and diplomat of the old school who served as Hitler's foreign minister from 1933 to 1938. Hans Oster, 1887 to 1945. A swashbuckling and charismatic intelligence officer whose outrage at Hitler's treatment of Werner von Fritsch in 1938 drove him to become one of the central players on the military side of the resistance movement. Wolfgang Ganz Erdler Herr zu Putzlitz, 1899 to 1975. A German diplomat whose anti-Nazi views led him to become an important agent for pre-war British intelligence. Erich Raeder, 1876 to 1960, commander-in-chief of the German Navy until 1943. Walter von Reichenau, 1884 to 1942, one of the few truly enthusiastic Nazis among the German generals. Joachim von Ribbentrop, 1893 to 1946. A sparkling wine salesman who played a significant role in Hitler's coming to power and then worked his way up to be foreign minister from 1938. Hjalmar Horace Greeley Schacht, 1877 to 1970. A half-American banker and financial expert who helped Hitler into power and became central bank president and minister of economics, but increasingly fell out with the Führer when Hitler refused to put economic rationality ahead of his armaments drive. Paul Schmidt, 1899 to 1970. An interpreter at the Foreign Ministry who served as Hitler's interpreter for numerous high-level diplomatic meetings in the 1930s and during the Second World War. Rudolf Schmundt, 1896 to 1944. The successor to Friedrich Hossbach as Hitler's armed forces adjutant from 1938 to 1944. Died of wounds received next to Hitler in the Valkyrie assassination attempt of July 1944. Count Lutz Schwerin von Krosigk, 1887 to 1977. Hitler's finance minister through the entire duration of the Third Reich. Clara Tisch, 1907 to 1941. A brilliant doctoral student in economics at Bonn University and protege of Joseph Schumpeter, she found it impossible to pursue her chosen career after 1933, and dreamed of immigrating to the United States. Jona Klopp von Ustinov, 1892 to 1962. A German journalist and employee of the German Foreign Ministry who worked as an agent for British intelligence in the Nazi era. Ernst von Weizsäcker, 1882 to 1951. A senior diplomat and state secretary in the Foreign Office under von Ribbentrop from 1938 to 1943, but involved with resistance circles. Erwin von Witzleben, 1881 to 1944. A blunt-spoken army officer, he was commander of the Berlin garrison in the late 1930s and joined the resistance in 1938. The British. Leo Amery, 1873 to 1955. A conservative MP and cabinet member whose fierce interventions in parliamentary debates had a powerful impact in 1939 and 1940. Duchess of Athol, Catherine Stuart Murray, 1874 to 1960. A conservative member of parliament and one of the pioneering women MPs from 1923 to 1938. The party deselected her over her opposition to Neville Chamberlain's appeasement policy, and she lost her seat. Clement Attlee, 1883 to 1967, Labour MP and leader of the Labour Party from 1935. Stanley Baldwin, 1867 to 1947, Conservative leader and three-time Prime Minister. With his matchless gift for finding and exploiting the political centre, Baldwin dominated British politics in the interwar years. Alexander Cadogan, 1884 to 1968. Permanent Undersecretary in the Foreign Office from 1938 to 1946. In his diaries, an often acerbic witness to the high-level politics of the time. Ronald Cartland, 1907 to 1940. An independent-minded young Conservative MP, first elected to the House of Commons in 1936, but heading for a collision with Prime Minister Chamberlain by the outbreak of war. Neville Chamberlain, 1869 to 1940. Prime Minister of the United Kingdom from 1937 to 1940. Highly competent, arrogant and caustic, with a visceral hatred of war, Chamberlain set himself the task of trying to find a permanent peaceful solution to the problem of Adolf Hitler. Winston Churchill, 1874 to 1965. Adventurous soldier and politician, holder of many high offices in the British government, Churchill had fallen far out of public esteem in the early 1930s when he started warning about the rising Nazi menace. Hugh Dowding, 1882 to 1970. Senior Royal Air Force officer in charge of research, development, and procurement through much of the 1930s, and then air officer commanding RAF Fighter Command from 1936 to 1940. One of the main architects of Britain's formidable air defense network. Alfred Duff Cooper, 1890 to 1954. An opponent of appeasement, he was First Lord of the Admiralty in Chamberlain's cabinet, but resigned in protest over the Munich settlement. Reginald Plunkett Ernie Earl Drax, 1880 to 1967. The Admiral sent to head the British delegation conducting talks with the Soviet Union about a potential alliance in the summer of 1939. Anthony Eden, 1897 to 1977.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.